Hello everyone, in this class we will discuss about future value of annuity. So future value of annuity is a series of constant cash flows, that is CCF, over a limited period of time, that is monthly rent, installment payments, lease rental, when a sequence of payments of some fixed amount are made in an account at equal intervals of time. There are two types of ordinary annuity. So they are as follows. So annuities is divided into two types, that is ordinary or deferred annuity, or second one due annuity. So ordinary or deferred annuity, so it is divided into future value, present value. Due annuity is also divided into future value and present value. So now future value of ordinary annuity, that is annual compounding. The value of annuity at some future time evaluated at a given interest rate, assuming that compounding take place one time in a year, that is annually. Two methods for calculation. So they are as follows. Future value ordinary annuity, that is annual compounding, is divided into general formula and factor formula. So again, general formula is divided into floating rate formula and constant rate formula. So let us now understand what are the formulas are. So first one, that is future value annuity of n is equal to cash flow into bracket 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 plus cash flow into bracket 1 plus I raised to n minus 2 plus cash flow 1 plus I raised to n minus 3 plus until cash flow 1 plus I raised to n minus n. So this is general formula floating rate. So or we can also apply future value annuity of n is equal to constant cash flow into bracket 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 divided by I. So this is general formula constant rate. Or we can also apply future value annuity of n is equal to constant cash flow into bracket future value interest factor annuity I percent comma n. So this is factor formula. So let us now understand what are the abbreviations are. So future value, that is FVAN, is equal to future value of ordinary annuity for n years. FVIFA, future value interest factor for annuity. CCF is equal to constant cash flows. I is equal to interest rate. This I also we can mention it as small k. So that is also nothing but interest rate. So n is equal to number of years. So let us now understand with the help of one example. Here we can apply above three formulas to this one problem. So example one is, if an employee deposits rupees 1000 at the end of each year into his company's plan, which pays 7% interest compounded yearly, how much will he have in the account at the end of 5 years? So this is the question. So answer is, we can apply above three formula to get one answer for this problem. So first formula we can apply here. So that is general formula floating rate. Future value annuity of n is equal to CCF into bracket 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 plus CCF 1 plus I raised to n minus 2 plus CCF 1 plus I raised to n minus 3 until CCF 1 plus I raised to n minus n. So this is the formula. So let us now put all the values in this formulas. Future value annuity for 5 years is equal to, this is CCF, a constant cash flow they have given here is 1000. That 1000 we have to put here, 1000 into bracket 1 plus 0.07. So 0.07 is nothing but what? 7% interest they have given in the problem. So that we have to convert it into decimal, it becomes 0.07. So raised to n minus 1, n they have given in the problem is 5 years. So 5 minus 1 plus 1000 into bracket 1 plus 0.07 raised to 5 minus 2 plus 1000 into bracket 1 plus 0.07 raised to 5 minus 3 plus 1000 into bracket 1 plus 0.07 raised to 5 minus 4 plus 1000 into bracket 1 plus 0.07 raised to 5 minus 5. So once we calculate value for this, it will arrive below 1. So refer third step. future value annuity for 5 years is equal to. So first one, that is 1310.7960 plus second one 1225.043 plus third one 1144.90 plus fourth one 1070 plus fifth one 1000. So once we add all these values, future value annuity for 5 years is equal to rupees 5750.74 will come. So this is the answer for this question. Again, we can apply second formula to get the value. So this second formula's value will also be same like 5750.74. That I will show you now. Okay, so second formula is general formula constant rate. So future value annuity of n is equal to CCF into bracket 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 divided by I. So future value annuity of 5 years is equal to 1000 into bracket 1 plus 0.07 raised to 5 minus 1 divided by 0.07. So future value annuity of 5 year is equal to 1000 into, so if we simplify that table, so that value comes to how much? It comes to 5.7507. that 5.7507, if we multiply with this 1000, so future value annuity for 5 years is rupees 5750.70 will come. So this is second formula's answer. So this is also same, we can apply this formula also. So last, we can also apply formula, that is factor formula. So I will show you now. Future value annuity of n is equal to CCF into bracket FVIFA I comma n. So for this formula, we need to refer table. So I already shared one table with you. So that table we have to refer here. So future value annuity for 5 year is equal to 1000 into bracket future value interest factor annuity 7% 5 year. So 7% 5 year we have to see in future value interest factor annuity table. So here you have to refer annuity table. Okay, so third one, future value annuity of 5 year is equal to 1000 into, so that table value, that is annuity table value, it comes to how much? It comes to 5.7507. Once we multiply with this 1000, it comes to how much? It comes to rupees 5750.70. so future value annuity after 5 years is equal to rupees 5750.70. this is the answer for this question. We can apply any one formula to this question. We need not worry about all formula, we need not apply to one problem. We can apply any one formula to this question. So this is the answer. So now let us move to example 2. So example 2 is, what is the future value of income stream which provides rupees 1000 at the end of year 1, rupees 2500 at the end of year 2, rupees 5000 during each of year 3 through 5 if the discount rate is 4%. So let us now solve by applying these formulas. So future value of n is equal to cash flow 1 plus I raised to n minus 1 plus cash flow into 1 plus I raised to n minus 2 plus cash flow 1 plus I raised to n minus 3 until cash flow 1 plus I raised to n minus n. So future value of 5 year is equal to cash flow, they have given 1000, so into bracket 1 plus interest rate they have given in the problem is 4%. So if we convert that 4% into decimal, it comes to how much? It comes to 0.04. so 0.04 raised to n they have given in the problem is 5 years. So future value of 5 year is equal to 1000 into bracket 1 plus 0.04 raised to 5.5 minus 1 plus 2500 for second year, so into bracket 1 plus 0.04 raised to 5 minus 2 plus for third year, this is 5000, 1 plus 0.04 raised to 5 minus 3 plus fourth year, it is also 5000 into bracket 1 plus 0.04 raised to 5 minus 4 plus fifth year also it is 5000 into bracket 1 plus 0.04 raised to 5 minus 5. So future value of 5 is equal to 1169.8586 is the first year answer, plus second year answer is 2812.16, plus third year answer is 5408, plus fourth year answer is 5200, plus fifth year answer is 5000. Once we add all these 5 year value, so future value NOT after 5 years, rupees 19590.02. So this is the answer for this question. So this is the answer. So let us now understand future value of NOT. That is intra-year compounding. So the value of NOT at some future time evaluated at a given interest rate, assuming that compounding take place more than one time in a year, that is intra-year. Interest rate reduced while period of time increase by frequency of compounding, that is indicated by small m, that is I divided by m and n into m. Two methods for calculation. So they are as follows. So future value of NOT, that is intra-year compounding, is divided into two types, that is general formula, second one factor formula. So formulas such as below. So future value NOT of n is equal to cash constant cash flow into bracket 1 plus I divided by m raised to n into m minus 1 divided by I divided by m. So this is general formula, or we can also apply factor formula. So future value NOT of n is equal to constant cash flow into bracket future value interest factor NOT I percent divided by m comma n into m. So this is the formula. So let us now understand with the help of one example in the next session. Thank you.